here. Vika Voroshino, she is Ukrainian and Russian. I served in student government with her a couple years back, and she has a couple things that she would love to say about communism.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening to all. Public speaking is extemporaneously, it's not my strong point, so I actually prepared my speech on my iPhone, so bear with me. My name is Victoria Voloshina. I'm a graduate student of political science at Portland State University. My heritage is Ukrainian, and I grew up in the Ukraine, United States of America. On this beautiful day, on the eve of Independence Day, I am deeply honored to be here tonight with the defenders of the freedom that our country was built upon in 1776. As a student, I am surrounded by liberal ideology and even strains of communism. Yet, to put into perspective what these political beliefs stand for, I have a couple family stories to share about how my grandparents and parents defied communism in times of the Soviet Union, when communism was the law of the land. Neither my grandparents nor my parents signed up for communism. In the fight to preserve their human dignity, determination, and right to practice their religion, they held on to the truth. This meant that practicing their faith within the atheist government was illegal. Their congregation met in secret, and when they were found, the community suffered substantial fines, abuse, imprisonment, and even death. In fact, it's the former government that raped people's homes, and they found one firearm. And on that, those rounds, they infected the entire family. My great-grandfather, Vladimir Krishnevsky, once commanded to hand over his farm when the communists came and declared that his part, or place in life, is now owned by the state. This is the farm that he worked on with his hands, the farm where he built his own house. The government decided to reappropriate land in name of so-called justice to all people and give an equal share to those that had not lifted a finger in their lives. Hereby take it in doing what is required to keep his family alive. Yet he did not let them take his humanity. He stood for what is right in helping others survive the imposed famines and hid people from death squads. As a fifth grader, I heard these stories from my grandparents and then heard the words in history class, history that was presented in class, of Patrick Henry. Give me liberty or give me death. This parallel between my Ukrainian family and the United States moves me beyond what we captured. Just today, my mother shared a poignantly ironic story about justice prevailing in the midst of these days of bleak, senseless horror. My mother personally witnessed the communists come to the place of worship with a German Shepherd attack dog. The communists decided to command the dog to attack, but pulled him back in order to make it a threat to the people. Well, this dog did not like the fact that it could not fulfill its order, so it turned around and attacked the communist leader.
Yay!
This Independence Day, I urge us to reflect on our personal histories and see the meaning of our independence through the fight of our forefathers and mothers. They are the reason that we are here today. As John Adams said, posterity, you will never know how much it costs the present generation to preserve your freedom.